The Gary is the voice for that.
I push the record button. That's always start my show.
Oh.
I push the record button.
So you've started.
I have started.
Oh my God. What is this? Where am I?
Where are we?
We're live.
We are live.
We're live.
Live from the garage.
The garage. You know what that means?
It's Phasing
Radio Line Now. Call the media.
We will call
Wait, the we're the media.
We are the media. I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG, and this
is Marty, KC1CWF, Portable 6, I guess.
Portable 6.
Portable 6, slash 6, stroke slick.
Marty's really here.
I'm going to prove it.
There we go. Marty's actually here in the studio.
In the studio. That's on
just,
my...
It's, no, I just messed up my...
There we go. My West Coast Odyssey.
West Coast trip, vacation out here.
Yeah.
You're taking...
I've done like the tour de ham.
Tour de ham.
Tour de ham.
Yeah, I wouldn't count my place in the tour de ham.
It's, you know... There
actually, there's a radio back
there. Ready? We can do this. The one radio, two radio, three radio, four radio, five radio.
There's a lot of radio.
Six
here.
Radio.
There's only a couple that work, though. There's a whole bunch. That's all junk.
10 radio. Radio.
Yeah.
11 radio. More radios than I own.
There's a lot of radios.
There's a lot of radio. So anybody who says this is not a ham station.
There's another radio.
A radio?
That's not the kind of radio we're talking about. That's a radio.
A radio?
That's a radio.
A radio? You have your phone? That's a radio?
Hi, radio.
It's a radio.
There's lots of radio.
Lots of radios.
Hi, Marty.
Hi.
Thanks for visiting.
Yeah.
We tried to get one more visitor, too.
He was at dinner.
Yeah.
Not even Subway.
And it wasn't Subway.
Yeah.
I really thought it was going to be Subway.
Yeah, we call Gary and he's, you know, he couldn't hear us and we were miming and he finally points it at the table. So
yeah.
No Gary.
They were having dinner.
Uncle G is not here for this one.
Not tonight.
Not tonight.
Well, you know, we'll cut him in later.
Yeah, we'll overlay his...
We'll paste a little.
Yeah, because remember, there's a time change. Like, I forgot there's a time change. I was calling my dad the other night. It's 6:30 at night. It's 3:30 in the afternoon. You know, that can get me in trouble.
Wait, you called him at 6:30 at night?
I called
it
him
was
at,
nine
I called him at
house.
8 o'clock at night, which was 11.
Oh, that was late.
And he's an old man.
Past his bedtime.
Exactly.
How old is your old man?
My old man is old.
How old?
50. If I get this wrong, he's going to strangle me.
Yeah, he will.
58, almost 59.
He's older than
you. He's older than you.
He is old.
Now you can feel good.
That's okay.
There
That's
we go. So I am here.
You're here.
I'm traveling. I'm on vacation.
Yeah, what are you doing on vacation?
I am living that good family vacation, you know, life. Santa Monica is where we're at. So
excellent.
Lots of cool.
Right near the pier.
Right near the pier. I saw Dave came driving in his yellow
my big truck.
Your big yellow radio truck.
My radio truck.
Radio truck. Had a very good lunch.
Yeah,
right?
we did.
We went out.
In and out.
In and
West
out.
West Coast favorite.
West Coast favorite. I feel like I've finally. Been able to, you know, pick up the tradition.
You did the thing.
I did the
we
thing.
We should have got you a t-shirt. Oh, well.
I went to Universal yesterday.
Yeah.
Love the thing. You know, checking the boxes.
How many rides did you do at Universal?
One.
Just one?
Just one.
Was it because of the lines?
The lines were
were they pretty bad?
They were pretty bad.
It was pretty busy.
But it's cool. You know,
wait,
I guess they've done it.
Christmas Day?
Christmas Day.
It was
Day.
Really crowded?
I don't know what really crowded looks like. I've never been there before.
How long did you wait in line for the Harry Potter ride?
The normal line was almost 3 hours, more than 3 hour wait.
That was
we waited less.
That was crowded.
Yeah.
You went in the
the single
rider.
Yeah.
Line.
But when you get to, it's funny at Universal, they have like a single rider line, which is if you're by yourself, you fill in the ride. So they put, they guarantee
four,
you
there's four seats across the carriage or whatever.
So they let you, they fill people in.
Right.
And the whole idea is you can skip the long line because you're just, you know, you're filler.
Right.
When you get to the very end of the single rider line, about like 100 feet before it ends, there is basically like the combining point where, like, if you're sneaky, you could just like jump into
the
regular people line and bypass the line.
Right. Maybe you can do that.
But it's actually cool. The Harry Potter ride, we're getting sidetracked. I'm mm-hmm. okay with that.
Mm-hmm.
It's Ham's been finding this interesting. It's on like a track, and on that track is like a 30-foot tall robotic arm.
Yep.
And you sit on that, and on that,
it's like a tractor.
It's a tractor,
right?
Right. Like envision, have you ever been to like a football game, like the camera crane, which is mm-hmm. on like a tractor with a big boom on it
mm-hmm.
and a platform at top? But instead of that platform, imagine like four seats across from like a roller coaster, and they strap you in and
and a big arm.
And a big arm.
And it twists you all.
It'd be so good for antenna work. Imagine if you could like put that into your backyard.
I got a friend down the road. Scotty needs his antenna removed. It's a 40-foot. That would be perfect for
yeah,
that.
Exactly. Just
pull you right up to it.
Take it down.
Take yeah. it down. A little gin pole attached to the side.
Yeah. You could put, you know, a little crane off the top.
Excellent. So you did the tour de Ham. I heard you went to Fullerton.
I went to Fullerton. I saw the famous, the legendary Dan Craig and 6MJ. That was super cool. Dan is certainly a renowned contester. So mm-hmm. that was very fun.
Don't know who Dan is.
Pull him up.
Okay, let me pull him up.
Yeah, we can.
I'm not a big contester. That's okay.
So N6MJ.
I have to find the QRZ thing.
Actually, there's a vid. Do you get sound over this or no?
Yeah.
Go to YouTube. Let's do that.
I could totally do sound.
I will narrate.
This is like high tech here.
This is a serious production.
But we have to make sure. Let's see. YouTube.
There's no music. You're okay. You won't get copyright.
Yeah, okay. So what am I looking for?
N6MJ.
N6MJ. You're going to say that like 14 more times.
Let's see. We can play. Wait till I bring this up. We'll play. We will play. Let's look at the 2015. 2016. Okay.
2 years ago?
Yeah. Actually, no. Go back. Yeah. So I'll pause it and explain what Dan is doing.
This one?
Yeah. You can.
2 years ago? 1 year ago?
Go.
2017?
Actually,
I can scroll down too.
Yeah, take this one for a second, and I'll explain. Just pause it, and then I'll explain what he's doing. So let's play. Let's play a couple seconds of it.
Okay, thanks. And for Zulu Charlie, 59 kilo. Cures that again. KT4Q, 59 kilo. N1ALO, 59 kilo.
So, believe it or not, what Dan is doing here, and we can keep the picture up if you want,
yep.
is he has two radios. These are two ICOM 7851s.
Uh-huh.
You know, $13,000 radios.
These are like that's the dual.
So that basically four receivers, right? If you think about it.
Yep.
So each of these radios are on a different band. He has two computers, two keyboards, two foot switches, one pair of headphones, one microphone.
Mm-hmm.
And he's running on two bands at once in a contest. So he's calling CQ on what I'm going to guess.
He's got two keyboards going.
I'm going to guess this is like 20 and that's 15.
Right.
So, you know, you'll see when he presses those top rows of buttons, that's F1. He's calling CQ.
Mm-hmm.
And then somebody calls back. All he says is, you know, the call sign and the signal report, because the rest he has saved in a voice keyer.
Right.
Which is, you know, it saves your voice. You just place it in a place in a wave file, basically. So when he says, you know, KC1CWF 59 kilo, W0DHD 59 kilo,
right.
What he might be doing is telling me on 20 meters, you know, Marty, you're 5'9".
Here's my call, and here's your signal report.
Right. And then he's doing the same thing over there, but what he's really doing is while he's saying that, he's listening for me to come back to him and give my state. And then when he's responding to you, he'll press the thanks KP3Z button on his.
Got it.
So there's he's doing two things at once. It's if you think like
and
running,
is he working both he's working both bands at
he's
the same
doing,
time.
Yeah, so you can
one in one ear and
one
in
the
other. Wow, my $1,000 radio behind you will it's not in the shot.
It's not in the shot.
Bring it over.
But
the
it's one radio.
It's know? One. It is one radio. Oh, this will do two.
Not
at the same time though. It has two. It has a yeah.
Yeah.
But it has a recorder in it, and I'm not doing that.
Not doing that. Not that.
So,
not for me.
So this is his contestation here?
This is not his contestation. It's the contestation he operates.
Oh, I see. K3P3Z.
Which is in Puerto Rico. But he primarily operates from, if you want to go back, I'll show you. There's another video in there.
Gotta go back.
We're gonna hear Bert in the comments commenting on this one already.
Oh, that's fine. Yeah, that's okay. Bring it on, Bert. I'm all good. I have no problem with that.
If you want to pull up that video. So anyways, I was having dinner with Dan, and we can bring up the audio. Let's just like listen to this chaos for a second. So you'll hear kind of the audio switching back and forth,
mm-hmm.
which is when he's hearing two ears, both radios are transmitting.
Yep.
And when you're hearing just one, the same thing in both ears, what you're hearing is just one radio because the other radio is transmitting.
Right.
So he's made the most contacts in the CQ Worldwide Contest of any single op station ever. He did that in 2015 with over 10,000 contacts in a 48-hour period.
Wow. He didn't get up at all.
I think he slept for 2 hours.
Did he?
But, you know, he's running in excess of a 300-hour right now.
Right.
300 QSOs an hour. And the interesting thing is it's the idea. The idea here is you're taking good rates, not great rates. You know, 200 QSOs an hour, which would be incredible for some, but, you know, fine for the extra location. Or 300 an hour. And combining them with another band that's marginal, you know, which might bring in another 200 an hour.
Right.
So when you combine, you know, that's how 500 Qs an hour is possible.
Got it. So you play the heavy one, and you find another one where you can get some on the side.
Yeah, but it's not like he's calling guys in the second radio. He's running on two frequencies at once.
So he's sitting on one, and he's pouncing on the other.
No, he's CQing on both.
On both. Oh, okay. He's calling on both.
This is advanced.
And that's a pretty massive setup that he's got there.
Yeah, this station is ZF1A. Zulu Fox 1 Alpha, the Cayman Amateur Radio Society station.
Mm-hmm.
That's the station of ZF2DX, I want to say. Mm-hmm. And at the station, you know, it holds a lot of records. It's not a huge station, you know, a couple tri-banders, but on 80 meters they have a two-element Yagi, which is a big antenna.
Somebody needs to do a GoFundMe to get him a better monitor on the left side there.
You know, he was telling me at dinner, they need to get new computers down there because, as you can see, it's an XP computer.
Right.
And it can barely run the software.
Oh, yeah. That's not that hard to update nowadays, because if it runs XP, it'll probably run 7. It'd be slow.
I think he said the computer had a quarter gig of RAM.
So maybe not.
Time for those Win 10 Intel NUX.
Yeah.
Do you play with NUX?
Uh-uh.
They're the Intel tiny little small form factor.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no. Anyways, we can kill this.
All right, we can kill this. But, that was cool.
That's who I saw for dinner.
So you went and saw N6MJ. You had dinner with him in Fullerton.
Right, and tomorrow brings a trip to San Francisco.
Right.
We will see.
By the bay.
In Cupertino. We'll see some hams out there.
So you said Tour de Ham up there.
Tour de Ham. This is the tour. It's an amateur tour of ham, I guess.
Excellent.
So what's going on in the W0DHG world?
What is going on here? You know, I've been I've been sick, and
I'm gonna go to San Francisco to sick tomorrow. Now.
No, I'm so much better now.
You're getting past it.
Yeah, it's been like 2 weeks, and through the antibiotics and done with all that stuff. I'm working on the studio a little bit here, as you can tell, it's just
very
as messy
fancy,
just as messy as always. Actually, cleared off some space. So I could get the radio up and running. Been working a little HF there.
I think this studio has the highest ratio of monitors to working radios of any studio I've seen.
Yeah. You think so?
We can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, you should see. There's
6,
a whole card.
7.
There's a whole card of them over there.
I'm looking for like the 19-inch CRTs.
Oh, there's a whole, no. There's no. We got rid of all the CRTs. There are no CRTs.
No CRTs.
I am a bad pack rat. I will admit that. But there are no CRTs.
No
left.
CRTs.
None
mechanical of them keyboards. No CRTs.
You know, this is a great keyboard. It's an awesome keyboard. Let's see. So what's been new? Working a lot. Doing some radio. Got some radio stuff coming up. Getting ready for Baker to Vegas. Wear my shirt. Baker to Vegas. Oh, really? So Baker to Vegas.
No,
is,
I know what.
It's
I said
the,
when.
When? Oh, March.
We did this show together. Remember?
Yeah, we did. Mm-hmm. March 27th, 28th of this
soon.
Year. So it's coming up.
Do you have your assignment for this year?
Yeah. I co-run Stage 9.
Stage 9.
Yeah, and I've been doing Stage 9 for, this will be my 7th or 8th year.
7th or 8th? That means he's more than 12.
Yes, I am more than 12.
Oh my God.
Yep. Been doing this for a little while. So get ready for that. I've been studying for my extra. I was going to take it next Saturday, but I think something else came up, and I'm not going to be able to be there.
See, you know, hams with excuses, you know.
No, it's a family more important thing to my kids, so I'm not doing that.
That'll be cool. You will have your extra.
I will, hopefully.
Are you going to get a new call sign?
Nope.
Not like W0DG?
It's not available. Nope. I, you know, maybe, but I don't think so. I already have the license plate on the wall here. Yeah.
There.
You can't see it. Oh, you can see
it. You can see it. Help.
There it is. Yeah, you can see part of it. And there's a real copy of that on my car. And so I'd have to get a new license plate. And the story, I don't know if I ever told you the story of my license plate, my ham radio license plate.
How long did it take?
It took 9.5 months.
9.5 months.
And the lady,
it's like having a child.
The lady who I called at the DMV when I got transferred through seriously talked to someone at San Quentin, which is a prison here in California. That's where they make our license plates. And she actually said, it's probably a shiv. We'll get you a new one. No, I'm not kidding. Not kidding at all. So I probably won't change my call sign. I don't, you know, I'm not a big contester, so CW isn't happening in my life. I do have a paddle over there. I'm learning.
I see this very...
I'm learning to use it.
He has a very nice Bencher BY1, the most sold paddle in America.
Yes, exactly.
Good choice.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. It was like $25 on eBay.
That's a good deal on a Bencher BY1.
Yes, it was. And so I know about five letters. So I think
changing, ready for a quiz?
Changing no. I think changing out my call sign is not in the cards. Not in the cards. I'm just working on I actually got another antenna that I'm going to put up soon. I have to take one down from a ham's house, a friend of mine, and when I take it down, then I'm going to...
What are you going
to
put up?
Whatever it is. Whatever he's got there, we'll put it up.
You don't know what it is.
I have no idea. It's a 40-foot roan, and it's... I think it's a 5-band...
TH5?
It's a 5-band Yagi. I don't know exactly what it is.
I want to come to your tower climb party. I'd take a path for you.
I have to. Well, first I have to get a cherry picker to get it down at his place.
Can you take it down from the tower?
No, he's going to take a cherry picker. It's been there for a long time, and everybody's worried about climbing the tower. Actually, so they want a cherry picker, and I had access to borrowing somebody's gin pole, but they went and looked at it, and they're like, no, no, no.
If you're not climbing it, you're not using the gin pole.
Yeah, that's what I think. Yeah. That's what we think. So I'm going to take it down, and then I have
to figure out... Towers go down so easily with cherry pickers.
I have to figure out about how big a hole I have to dig here and concrete and put it
Let's take a walk. Can we take a look at it before we leave? Can we take a look at your yard?
Yeah, we can look at my yard. Yeah, we can't look at Sky.
I know, I was going to say, can we see your yard?
Far. Yeah, we can look at the yard. Yeah, and Marty will tell me exactly where I need to put it. Yeah. I know where it's going to be. It's going to be right next to the deck where my parents live.
So it falls on...
No, so my mom will hate it every minute of it, which is where I want it to go.
I hope she doesn't watch this.
No, she won't. I'm absolutely sure she won't. You know, the problem is that I live in a canyon. There's a hill on one side, and then there's a hill
it's
on the other.
It's a gorgeous canyon, then.
It is. It is a nice canyon, but it's not a good.
It's a canyon.
It's not a good RF canyon.
But you're,
a couple times I've worked the driveway. I put it up on my. I have the flagpoles that go in the hitch on my Jeep, on my truck, and I pull it out. And
you love calling that thing a truck.
when they did W1AW, I worked. Utah and Wyoming on my first call for both states on 20 meters through the pile up, and I got 5-9s. But I know based on watching the video you just showed me, everybody always reports 5-9s, even if it's a junk signal because it's in their recorder there, right?
It's quicker to say, if I have to think about it, if I'm working at that, 300 guys an hour, everybody's a 5-9.
Well, you don't want to have to sit there and look at the meter.
I mean, one could get into a debate that most meters on most ham radios are not calibrated, so it's
that's true.
Ridiculous if you say 5.9,
Well, 5.9 here is what I see on my, on the screen on mine when I put it through. It comes through 5.9, and sometimes I see, and I could call it what it is, but like you said, it's too much time.
There are calibrated, if you have the signal strength of dBm, you could generate a accurate 5.9.
No. There was a lot of that when we went to Last Man Standing. I mean, you could tell me there was a lot of that at Last Man Standing. We'd get a lot of good signal reports, and I watched Gary do it, and nobody was looking at them.
Making it up.
No, and plus the noise was so bad.
I was pleasantly surprised.
There on Saturday.
You know the secret.
Everything was
off. I thought I was going to pass that off on you. all the lights were off. All the cameras were off. All the mics were off. Yep.
In that building and all the buildings surrounding it.
Yes.
Yeah.
I thought I'd get that one.
No. I mean, I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed, but I know that one. I have a friend who's the satellite RF engineer for that whole site. And I keep trying. I got to talk to him about going over there to see John and... helping him out to see what they can do to cut some of the noise.
John like pointed at the air conditioning unit and he said, "Oh, there's half your problem."
Yeah.
And then you look at the solar cells on the roof.
Yeah, there's probably your problem. And they had He brought in a box. I'm not allowed to say what brand it is or model number. But he brought in a box that was supposed to help clear up some of
the
stuff.
The noise canceler.
Yeah, the noise canceler.
Yeah, I can't talk about the noise canceler.
We're not supposed to talk about the noise canceler. And at one point, Cliff noticed that we were only outputting like 25 watts. We took the noise canceler off, and then we were outputting 100 watts, and it was way better. But I'm not talking about the noise canceler.
We know nothing about a noise canceler.
I don't know anything about it.
Station worked really well. You know, nice.
It was 610. It was a beautiful station. Yeah, it's a nice station. If I wanted to have one of those here, I could sell my car and
your house and your three children.
Some of the junk that's on the other side of my garage to help pay for it. And that can happen. But I like my...
But you could also build a television studio.
I could. Well, I did. Kind of. And Marty could tell you looking around here, I didn't really build it. I kind of just threw it together with...
You know, very nice desk selection. I like the desks.
Well, this was a fail. So what I'm working from right now was an offering that came up from my son's Eagle Scout project garage sale that somebody brought over because they didn't need any more.
And it didn't sell.
It didn't sell. And it ended up in my yard because my wife thought it would be part of her pottery studio, which is just outside the door.
Did you?
And then I thought, you know, I had a one of these plastic tables, but it shook too much. Yeah, that one does it more. And it shook too much. And then I thought, you know, this one has some potential possibility. This one works way better. It's small. It's a little too small for me sometimes. I think it'd be nicer to have a bigger desk here. And Marty has the luxurious...
I have a pleather top desk.
It's pleather topped. It's a coffee table. It's a card table. So you should be playing Mahjong.
Extremely deluxe.
Yep. And then there's the whole background. Everything here in the background is real, including Arvin. Except, you know, the FJ is not real.
Is Arvin? You don't have a big Arvin. That's the only Arvin. I have a squeaky Arvin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you pick him up? Shake him.
You hear?
Yeah.
You can hear. There's money in it.
There's money. My daughters came in.
I was going to say, the only people putting money in this. But if you like the show, if you care about it, you know what you got to do? You got to feed the pig.
How do you feed the pig? Go visit hamradionow.tv. Find Arvin and click the pig. And also there's a Phasing Line. You guys have...
Yeah, you can do a couple things. PhasingLinePodcast.com.
Wait, here.
Please, we will make more shows. You click that donate button.
Donate.
See that?
Right
donate,
here at the top.
Donate. And you scroll down. You can become a patron on Patreon.
That's the best.
You can do all those plosives.
That's the best. Or you can do one-time PayPal.
Or
you have Bitcoin?
We can do Bitcoin.
Wow. I'm not doing Bitcoin.
You can do Bitcoin. I didn't know we could do Bitcoin.
Was that Sterling?
I was Sterling.
Awesome.
I'm just going with it here.
You're like, I'm
going
to put this number up here because it means something. Hopefully this is not...
That's like a hash ID, whatever.
Yeah. That's your key to your Bitcoin.
My key.
Your Bitcoin locker.
All I knew is I owned a bunch of Bitcoin. I sold Bitcoin and then Bitcoin crashed. So yeah. I'm happy.
Good? Worked out all right?
It worked out right for me. I'm not playing in Bitcoin anymore.
All right. You know, way back in the day...
I got into Bitcoin way back into the... In the
way
day.
Back in the day when it first was out, you were probably too small to...
Oh, it was given to me when I was very small.
Yeah.
So Bitcoin is not that old.
I thought about at least
10?
15 years. Yeah, they were mining this thing, and I remember hearing about it. And this was when...
But you could actually make money with
it. Actually, it was probably more than that because 17 years... No, see, 15 years ago we moved into this house. It was probably like 16 years ago. Don't worry about the chair.
Were you going to set up a Bitcoin operation?
I got a PC from a friend of mine that was a rack case that had two motherboards. It was running two Pentium motherboards, and it had like 16 drive slots in it. And
you're going to do like drive mining?
And I was going to do it, and then I thought... I don't want to hear that thing run all night, all the time. Because
well,
it was in my office.
If you got in on it then,
yeah,
and you kept the Bitcoins,
I'd have a real studio here.
You would not be working.
Yeah. Well, fail.
But there are people who lost millions of dollars worth of Bitcoins like a year ago, almost exactly. So
yeah. Oh, well.
Don't ask me about crypto.
I have nothing. I got nothing on that. So How's the phasing line going, Marty? I know. I shouldn't say anything because it's been a while since I've had a show out.
We just published a show.
Did you?
Must have been 6 months ago.
Got it. Sterling's been busy.
Sterling is no longer Sterling Copy. Sterling is no longer N0SSC.
He's not?
No.
What?
I think he's like KQ. Maybe he changed it back to N0SSC. Yeah, I think that's what he did.
Did he?
But if you go to like details.
No longer. Wait, because I'm not logged in. So Sterling changed his call.
He was like KQ0B, I think. Maybe.
Come on.
We're really struggling with the computer
here. I'm struggling here. Well, because you threw me off with the whole Sterling changed his call sign thing.
But like when you go to the detail thing, you can
see. Yeah, you can do the
KQ0B, right?
You see it?
KQ0.
Oh, sorry. Oops. Did I click too quick?
Yeah, former previous call sign, KQ0B.
So he switched back.
King, queen, zero, bravo.
King,
queen,
zero. No, king, Quebec.
Kilo, Quebec.
Kilo, Quebec, zero, bravo. Yeah.
King, queen, 2B. 0B.
0B. Cool. That's a nice call. It's short.
It's
shorter than N0. See, that's the thing. But he's not.
It's not a bad. It's not a bad. Not,
Sterling Coffee anymore, so he needs to be N0SSM.
SSC is not a bad. Sugar Sugar Charlie isn't terrific.
Or Sugar Sugar Mike.
But it's very the issue on code, Sugar Sugar Charlie.
Yeah. I'm not a big code guy. Sugar Sugar.
You know what SOS is, right?
Yeah, I know, but I don't know the difference between Charlie or Mike. Because that's really the important letter in this part that he changed.
C is dot it dot it and Mike is da da.
So Mike would be better.
Mike would be better. You want a call to end in a da, not a dit.
Right.
Because, you know, like the joke is a local in Boston is K1TTT, da 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 da.
I got a friend who's TTT.
Da 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 is a lot better than like HHH.
Got it.
If you don't know code, figure it out.
Yeah. It's longer.
That's, you know, the other joke, the funny call sign in ham radio for me has always been Echo Echo 5 Echo. E E 5 E. Remember, E is dit.
Dit.
And 5 is 5 dits.
So it's just all
so
dits.
So you have dit, 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 dit.
E, five, yeah. Where's that? Where's E? Where's
Echo E Echo. Then? What?
Where's Echo Echo Land?
There's your.
Yeah, it shows homework. I'm not a DXer.
Echo Echo so, 5 Echo.
So you guys made it to 24, and that
24.
Was. 24. That's so 20, a while ago.
25 is shot. Actually, 26 was shot. You know, there's this thing when you like do the live on location with the men and women of ham radio.
It's a lot of work.
You have to post-produce them.
Yeah.
And I have a great show that was shot at like 2 a.m. with certainly a tipsy Sterling and maybe a little bit, a completely sober Jerry Ellsworth. And that'll be a really fun show.
Wow.
We shot that at like 2 a.m. in Dayton. Like,
that's celebrities.
20 minutes into the show, I was falling asleep.
Because it was so late.
And they're all night owls.
Right.
And it was like 2:33 by the time we finished. But, you know, we cover everything from like flex radio to virtual reality in ham radio.
Oh.
To radio politics to chip design to
everybody wants C64. To see that. Why did you
if you like give this thing enough thumbs up, I'll publish it.
You got to get it up there.
I actually have it on an external hard drive with me.
Is it done?
I normalize the levels, cut out the beginning, cut out the bend, throw in.
This is why Gary quit doing ham radio podcast because it's too much work.
Because you by the time you like shoot an intro and edit it together and put it over a music pad, it's like the way you do live, like switched in real time. You don't realize how much less work it is.
Yeah, I can imagine.
It's like when you shoot.
I can because I did a couple shows. What did I do? Oh, I did the Arden show where.
Oh, so you like load it in. You have to clean up the clips, and then you like multicam switch it. You throw in all the graphics. It's a lot of work.
That's what I did.
It's a lot of work.
That's what I did.
Yeah. It was probably several hours.
It was a lot of work. Oh gosh,
I think I did 10 hours.
I think I did an hour show. I think it probably took me 10 hours.
Yeah.
To put it all together. And that didn't include like going out in the field
and
to shoot.
And it wasn't
all.
Like you're coloring it. It wasn't like.
Oh no, I didn't do anything really technical. Right. I was just clipping the ends and like figuring out how to make it look.
Right,
look
and then you have to go in and physically watch the show, and it normally takes twice as long to switch it.
What's the order? And how does it look? And,
you know, are you using the wide shot too much? You know, do you have to, you know, put a corner pin on the projector shot?
Marty knows all this stuff. He's got the high technology going.
Feed Arvin.
Ooh, feed Arvin. We'll have more.
How's Arvin's feeding doing?
You know, it's okay. It's dropped since Gary left. People were annoyed when Gary left. There were a lot of people that went into the, is this your work here? It's all good.
I don't know what it was.
There's, this was probably there were a lot of people that were annoyed when I, when Gary left, that people said I should have got my own show and I shouldn't have stole this from Gary. But, you know, honestly, Gary didn't want the show anymore and he wanted to give it up.
It's real.
And I wanted to. Yeah, it is.
It's also not their show, so they can.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's okay. I take all those people who say that and then I suck with just a grain of salt and think, that's okay.
Hi, Bert.
Yeah, it's okay. I don't mind. I'm enjoying doing this. I have fun out here.
But we got, you know, it's very official because, you know, we have a.
Yeah, I work for an entertainment company, so we get these from that. That was like a prop in they had some meeting and they had these on the table and they were going to get rid of them. I had to keep it. That's the kind of Pat Rock I am. But you know, we get Patreon is covering. Let's just put it this way: the Patreon and the donations I get, it covers my bills. I have to pay for hosting. I have to pay for Squarespace.
It's not cheap.
I have to pay for Libsyn, for the pod. How do you do the pod? How do you do your pod stuff?
Pod what? Like RSS?
Yeah. How
do you do all through Libsyn.
You do it through Libsyn. So you got to pay for that too.
Yep.
And
everybody uses Libsyn primarily.
Yeah, because it works. It's easy. And, I mean, it's, you know, it's.
We upload directly to Libsyn. They do all of our content serving.
Yeah, I send it to them for the podcast parts, for the stuff I'm not doing video. The rest of it goes through.
Right, we don't do video.
Squarespace. And, you know, basically it covers the bills and I buy a little toy now and then to show on the show, you know,
toy to make the show better.
Yeah, exactly. Or a toy to make the show better. Yeah. So like you're talking in that mic, I bought that mic. Gary sent me the flag. Actually, Gary carried the flag here.
Oh, the mic flags.
Yeah. Oh no, the thing's not plugged in behind me. But you can't see it anyways.
What?
The Ham Radio Now sign.
Does it light? Oh, it lights up.
It lights up. I'd have to plug it in. Hold on a second.
Ugh.
You keep talking while I plug it in.
Anyways, so I am crashing the house. Your show is going good. My show is if we get 20 people give this episode a thumbs up, I will produce that show. Woo-hoo. And if we don't, I will. It'll just take a while.
Well, that means that's really easy then, because I have the 7 hams that live in this house.
Yeah, exactly.
Actually, 6 hams that live in the house. So unfortunately, I turned it on. Oh, there it is.
There it is.
Up there it is.
If anybody wants to make one of those and send it to the Phasing Line, you can find my address on QRZ.
that's cool. It's totally cool. So Gary brought that.
Do you have like the remote to change the colors?
Yes and no. Yes, I have the remote. And no, the batteries are dead.
It doesn't change the
colors. It actually does. The batteries are dead. I need to go get a battery. It's a 2025. I already pulled it out and know what it is, but I just haven't had a chance to do that yet. And I know when
CR 2025.
Yeah, if you want to send me one of those. Gary, when Gary brought it here, it was dead. But Gary had decided that green was the right color, so he didn't realize that it was dead. It was just always on green, and it always stayed on, and so it didn't matter. But when Gary came out to do Last Man Standing, he brought that. He brought me the flags. I forgot to put a shirt on. He brought me the green.
Oh, the green
Radio Now shirts.
And he brought you the vest.
I didn't get a vest. Did you have a vest? And shirts. And I wore them. I wear them almost every episode. I forgot to wear them today.
It's really kind of ugly color green.
It's all right. It's kind of cold in the garage here, except for Marty, who's from.
I'm wearing shorts
from Boston. What's the temperature say on the thing there?
64.
Yeah, 64 degrees.
64. It's hot.
We can hang meat in here.
We can go swimming.
It's cold. Oh, the pools are really cold. You don't want to go in the pools.
I was
cold.
In the ocean this morning.
Wow. So So Ham Radio Now is treating me pretty good, and I'm still trying to do. I committed to 2 episodes a month, and almost every month I hit that. And the biggest challenge, and I don't know how this works for you, the biggest challenge for me is finding people that will come and talk to me on a consistent basis.
See, I don't need guests
that show up. You just like to do this on your own.
Yeah. Sterling and I self.
Yeah, you guys play off each other.
Yeah.
That's what I had Gary. We played off each other. Every once in a while, Darren will sit in that seat and we'll do a show. And that works out okay.
Daryl is like a media maven.
I have a hard time sitting here and just talking to myself.
That's the different. That's what experience brings.
Yeah. 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 That's challenging.
All right.
But I got a couple ideas. Yeah. And we'll work on some.
What is this object you keep spinning in your hands?
This is my Lucy. It's you know, it's here. So I don't put it on camera. It's just something. It's a light.
It's light.
It's LED light. It's camping light, Lucy light. Here, I'll plug them for free. Here, you can see. It blows up. It doesn't weigh a whole lot. It's solar powered. You can deflate it, and it's backpacking. It's camping. We do a lot of camping. Lots of Boy Scouts stuff going on here. And so it's light.
How do I get to the...
One more time. Flashing?
Red. Oh, there it is.
And if you read it... Wait. You have to read it.
SOS.
Yes. That's what the only thing red's good for. And doesn't white.
You don't use the red flashing SOS when you just want to say hi to the Coast Guard.
I guess. Yeah, I'm waving this because I'm saying
hi. Hi there.
I didn't know.
How are you?
I thought they don't do SOS anymore.
Well, I mean, if you write SOS on the beach and they fly, they'll know they're looking for you and your e-perb's going off.
I would write help. I don't know if I'd write SOS. I'd write help. I'd actually buy that extra vowel. Actually, it's not a vowel. I'd buy the extra consonant. Yeah, I'd buy that thing and make it four letters.
We are professional pronunciators.
But, you know, I guess it makes sense because SOS would be in any language, whereas help might only be in English. What happens if somebody French flies over?
Le help?
Yeah, what does help mean? They're advertising something. They want us to stop there and buy it. We're not going to do it.
It's a French cosmetic.
So you got this show with Jerry Ellsworth.
I'm
jealous.
And we just published the Puerto Rico show.
We published,
really special to shoot.
Yeah,
tremendous honor.
You didn't go there live. You talked to the guys at Dayton. Yeah.
You going to Dayton?
No. I don't get enough time off. I might go to Yuma this year.
Yuma's
close. Yuma.
You took today off.
Yeah, kind of, sort of. I got up really early. I got up really early. And I started working very early this morning. So enough with that. And we have the every other year we get the PacificCon Torrance.
Is PacificCon every other year?
No, it's every year up north, but then they switch it up north, down here, upper north, something like that. So I'll do the one that's
PacificCon
here.
PacificCon is supposedly terrific.
Yeah. I want to go to BayCon just because it has a cool name.
Is that in the Bay Area?
Yeah, in the Bay Area because it has a cool name.
Would you fly up or would you drive up?
I would drive. Probably drive. It's like 6 hours.
Is it cheaper to drive or fly? It's probably about
the
same.
It depends on whose car you drive.
Yeah.
Because my car gets gallons to miles.
Gallons to miles.
So it's not. My wife's car is way cheaper to.
Miles to gallons.
Yeah, exactly. Hers gets twice what I get.
I am flying tomorrow on points.
Yeah, you're going on points? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
You get lots of points. You got a lot of traveling going on.
Yeah. Here. I'm still my mom's former career had her traveling a lot, and I'm still burning off those.
We used those last summer to send the kids. My wife travels for work, and we sent the kids here and there and everywhere. So what kind of ham radio stuff do you have planned for
2019? Hopefully a contest operation from HQ9X, Roatan, down south, off of Honduras.
Cool.
A contest operation from K3LR. Which, if you've never heard of K3LR.
I've heard of K3LR. I can't tell you where it is, but I've heard of that.
You can...
That's like Superstation, K3LR, right?
Yeah, probably the biggest station in North America.
Right.
Tim, K3LR, is the owner... I've misspoke. I apologize. The manager of DX Engineering.
Right.
And if you look at the...
There's a big list of...
The big list of antennas.
It almost looks like their catalog.
We can go. There's there's two stations on every non-war contest band. 160, 80, 40, 20, 15, and 10, and one station on 160 meters. The biggest antenna array there is probably the 40-meter run antenna.
Wow.
Which is a 12-element array, or four-element Yagi at close to 300 feet, four-element Yagi at around 200 feet,
and
four-element Yagi.
That's this tower here, right?
No, that's the...
That's the smaller one.
That's one of... So I think he has 8 or 9 towers. On 80 meters, for example, he has a 8-element vertical array, 2 4 squares, which are quarter wave spaced in phase.
Is he phone or worldwide?
Go to DX phone. That was recent.
This is all this year.
Yeah, those are all this year.
Are you
so
there?
You can see... I'm not there. No. But you can see like what the station... Yeah, there's a pick a couple of the towers. But, you know, on 20 meters, I believe, the run station on 20, remember, because you have two stations on each band, you need two sets of antenna. Mm-hmm. The run station has a 250-foot tower with a stack of six-element Yagis on 50-foot booms.
And you work out of this barn?
Yeah. I've never been there before. I'm very excited. So there are, 24 elements in phase on 20 meters. That's the run 20-meter station right there.
Mm-hmm.
With excuse me, that's 15. I've misspoke. That's Doug, K1DG. And that's 20 meters. That's the multiplier station at K3LR. That's John, K1AR. And Andy, N2NT, with the gold-plated IC7850 limited edition at the 20-meter run station at K3LR. And then there you can see Andy NP4G and Andy N2NT. And you can see NP4G and Andy N2NT there. And most likely that looks like 15, but I can't tell.
Cool. So you're hoping to go work there.
So I am going to do, we're planning a youth multi two for the CQWPX phone contest.
Uh-huh.
So that's in late March, and we're fundraising to do that.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
So we're calling ourselves Team Exuberance.
Uh-huh.
TeamExuberance.org is the website. Can you look up?
I can look it up. Yeah, okay.
And we are trying to raise $5,000 to make it happen. And we're approaching $4,000. That's not quite reflected in
quite spelled right either.
GoFundMe, uh-huh. Because some money was sent in checks. We haven't updated the GoFundMe.
Got it.
But if you look at the GoFundMe there, you will see that I believe we're probably about $35.50.
Oh, okay.
Getting there. So if you think what we're doing is cool, before you feed the pig and before you feed the phasing line, click the donate.
Look at that. That is a setup there.
That's like what the W0DHG station will look like in a couple
someday,
weeks.
Someday, because he doesn't live in an HOA for sure.
Yeah. Is this an HOA?
No. Nope. I can put up anything I want, and the only... Yeah, no, I'm not going to go there. Nobody's going to complain. Well, you know, I have to get a permit, and the city of LA will catch me, is what I've been told. But if I get a permit, I get it approved, and as long as I meet all of the rules and requirements, I'm good to go with whatever I want. And all the antennas that are already on the roof, nobody asked me about.
There's one that's
kind of
crooked. He has what do you call it?
It's a vertical. It's mounted horizontal. It's not quite horizontal.
I was going to say it's a diagonal polarization.
Yes, exactly.
Pendant.
Something happened to that. I think a big bird sat on it. A hawk got on it and banged it down a little bit. Maybe so you're going to do that? You're going to do that trip?
Yeah. Come back, hang out with the family, and then back to Boston.
Back to Boston.
B2B.
And you're going back over New Year's.
Over New Year's. And then I will never see the ball drop over any one region because I will be chasing.
Chasing it all. What time do you leave?
I believe I leave here at maybe it's 10 o'clock at night.
Oh, well, if you stand in the bar in the airport and you watch them do Times Square, you can see the ball drop at 9 o'clock.
Maybe it's 9:30. I'll be on the... I don't know.
Oh, okay. Cool.
I don't know.
Bummer.
All right.
Okay, but by the time you get there, it'll be there.
Yeah, exactly.
Cool.
So... this has been a phasing radio line now.
Yes. Thank you for joining me. I'm so glad you were able to come out.
Come back next week for next week's episode.
So we're going to close it out.
Over.
And out.
73.
Wait, we'd have to push this button thing. Where'd it go?
Where's the animation?
Here it is. You can't see it because I'm in that mode. But it worked. I really hope it worked. I think it worked. I'm going to hit the stop recording button.
And we're done.